captain of 44 Hours. Fairgreen International School proudly presents Peter Pan Jr., Cast 1.
Michael?
John.
Mother!
Oh, Mother, you look lovely.
Why, thank you. What are you doing in my old hat?
We're playing a video. Father.
Mother, they never let me play. Father, they never let me dance.
Well, we'll soon fix that.
Mother!
What is the matter, Georgia?
Matter? This tie, or not tie. Now on my neck, on the bedpost, oh yes. But on my neck, oh dear, no.
I won't take a bath, Mama, I won't take a bath.
I won't be bathed at once, sir. Oh, Mother, look here. Hair all over my trousers. Clumsy.
I'll wash you up, Father, dear.
Thank you. You know, Mother, sometimes I think it's a mistake to have a dog for a nurse.
George, we must keep Nana. I'll tell you why. When I came into this room tonight, I saw a face at the window.
A face at the window? 2 floors up?
It was the face of a little boy. He was trying to get in.
Impossible.
But wait, the boy was not quite alone. He was accompanied by, I don't know how to describe it, by a ball of light that darted around the room like a living thing.
That is very unusual.
George, what can all this mean?
Oh, clumsy. Just look at my trousers covered with hair again. I refuse to allow that dog in my nursery for 1 hour longer.
Oh, Father, please, Father.
Am I master in this house, or is she? Come on, Nana. Come on, Nana. Nice, Nana, dear. Pretty, Nana. Good job.
Oh, Father, please, Father.
He's awfully unhappy.
That's not her happy dog. That's her puppy. She's not dangerous.
But anything harmless, Father, after the night lights are lit?
Nothing precious. They are the eyes of Mother leaves behind to guard her sleeping children. Now sing your goodnight song and into your beds.
Wendy Moyer and her darling. What's your name?
Peter Pan.
And where do Sandy lives.
Second to the right and straight until the morning.
What a funny guess.
No, it isn't.
I mean, is that what they put in your letters?
I don't get any letters.
But your mother gets letters.
I don't have a mother. Wendy, I can't get my shadow to stick on.
It's come off. How awful. I shall sew it on for you.
Thank you.
I dare say. It might hurt a little.
I never cry.
Done.
Oh, look, Wendy, look. My shadow. Oh, I'm clever. Oh, the cleverness of me.
Oh, Peter, you're so clever. Shall I give you a kiss? Do you know what a kiss is?
I shall know when you give it to me. Now, shall I give you a kiss?
If you please. A button. I shall sew this on this chain around my neck. Peter, how old are you?
I don't know. I went away from home the day I was born.
Ran away? Why?
Because I heard father and mother told me what to be when I'm a man. I always want to be a little boy and to have fun. So I ran away to live a long time among the fairies.
Peter, you really know fairies?
Yes, but they're nearly all dead now.
Dead? Why?
You see, Wendy, when the first baby laughed for the first time, the laugh broke into a thousand pieces, and they all went skipping about, and that was the beginning of fairies. So every time a child laughs for the first time, the laugh becomes a fairy. So there ought to be a fairy for every boy or girl.
Ought to be? Isn't there?
No, Wendy. Children these days are so smart. Soon they don't believe. Every time a child says, "I don't believe in fairies," there's a fairy somewhere that drops down dead.
Poor things!
I can't think where she has gone to. Tinkerbell! Tink! Tink!
Peter! There's a ruler fairy in this room!
She came with me. Wendy, I believe I shut her up in that drawer. You're in that drawer.
What did she say?
She's not very polite. Tinkerbell, you know you can't be my fairy because I'm a gentleman and you're a lady.
Don't worry, she's chained up. Peter, where do you live?
Neverland.
Neverland? What does it look like?
It's an island hardly in the space between an adventure and another.
Neverland! Oh, who else was that, Peter?
The Lost Boys.
Who are they?
They're children who fall off the prams when the nurses look in the wrong way. If they aren't cleansed in 7 days, they are sent off to Neverland. I am captain.
Oh, what fun it must be.
Yes, but we're rather lonely and none of us knows any stories.
How perfectly awful.
Wendy, your mother was telling you such a lovely story about the prince who couldn't find the lady in the glass slipper.
Oh, that's Cinderella. I lived happily ever after.
I'm glad.
Peter, where are you going?
To tell the lost boys.
Oh, Peter, I know lots of stories.
Do you?
Oh, stories I could tell the boys.
Come on, now we'll fly. How we shall all respect you.
Peter, you really know how to fly.
I'll teach you.
Can you teach John and Michael to fly too?
If you like.
John Michael, wake up! There's a boy here who's going to teach us to fly.
It's... No, get up at once!
Out the light! Someone's coming!
There you see, the perfectly sound is safe asleep in bed. Now no more. Come along, you naughty dog.
All clear.
Can you really fly?
I'll teach you.
How do you do it?
You just think lovely, wonderful thoughts. And up you go.
Oh, how sweet!
of you. Now think lovely thoughts.
Think lovely thoughts.
Fishing.
Hopscotch.
Candy.
Picnics.
Summer.
Candy.
Sailing.
Flowers.
Candy.
Lovely thoughts, Michael.
If I were a mother, I'd pray that the children would be born with this instead of that. But Pan flung me hand to a crocodile that happened to be passing by.
I often noticed your strange red crocodiles.
Not of crocodiles, but of that one crocodile. He liked me hand so much, he's followed me ever since. From land to land, from sea to sea, following the ship, licking his lips for the rest of me.
Compliments.
Well, I want no such compliments, me. That girl would have gone me long ago if he could have crept upon me unawares. But by some lucky chance, swallowed the clock.
A clock?
And it goes on. Tick, tock, tick within him. And before he can reach me, I hear the tick.
But someday that clock will run down. And then I'll get you.
Aye, that is the fear that haunts me.
What's the matter, Captain?
This is hot! It's hot! It's really hot! A chimney? Peter and the boys must be living on the ground.
Listen.
Call back the band. They say that Peter's away from home. I must think. Inspire me.
What tempo, Captain?
Tempo. Tempo. Andiamo!
And you're cuter. Look at her.
She lives.
See the arrow struck against this? It's a kiss I gave her.
Aye, that's a kiss. I remember these.
Wendy, are you awake? Don't you want to get up and play?
I know, let's carry her into the house.
No. Don't touch her. That wouldn't be sufficiently respectful. I know. We'll build a house around her.
A house!
I have a plan. Let's be right as a mouse and build a lovely darling house for Wendy. Oh, for Wendy. She's here to stay.
And be your mother.
The ship. Now
bait because you're lost in. Peter, don't get your medicine before you jump me.
I'm not coming.
Yes, Peter.
No, Wendy. Why? I don't want to grow up and learn about some things. And no one's going to catch me and make me a man.
We're ready to go now.
Peter's not coming.
Peter's not coming? Then I won't leave him.
Now then, no blubbering, no crying, just say goodbyes.
Goodbye, Peter.
Clap, 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 clap
Goodnight Brown with a goodnight chocolate, and the toad drowsily searching for belated crumbs, housed insecurely on their shining cheeks. Compare them to the captive children of this boat. Split me the infinitive, but 'tis the hour of triumph. Ha ha ha! At last I've reached my peak. I'm the greatest villain of all time.
Thank you.
fight to die. You will die with me.
Save us, Peter! Save us!
In 2 minutes, the ship will blow up into pieces, and that will take care of all of us.
Oh, please! Save us, Peter! Save us!
Forever and ever and ever now. You've worked at this. I know you've had whole days of school that you've practiced. I know you've probably been running up and down the stairs at home, singing in the bathroom, practicing your lines, trying on your outfits, and we're all super, super proud of you. So everybody right now is going to give you another big round of applause. Well done. Must be at age, I'm looking at some of the youngest here, 5 and 6, to get your first standing ovation in life. And someone's holding up 4 fingers, so we've got even younger than I was first anticipating there. And what I love is I've known some of these children since they're in preteen as well, and it's amazing to get them to see them come up and perform like this. So we are, like I said, truly proud of all of you, and to parents, I'd like to say a special thank you for all your support as well in getting the children to this point. So one more round of applause, please. Now don't forget, as a school, this is the first of 2 performances for this past. We also have a performance on Wednesday, and we have a performance on Thursday for our past too. So we've got 4 special nights here at Fairgreen this week. So I hope to see some of your faces again during the week coming along to celebrate our children and all they've achieved. Now, a couple of final notes from me. First of all, you may have noticed a new addition for the production this year, and that we made 2 children fly. I want to say a special thank you to the Ringing Company, who have been so unbelievably generous giving our applause. And having an element of your activity senior school production, we're so very grateful for your support and help leading to today and this week. And also, children, I'm just going to ask you tonight, we'll single everyone out at the end of the performances, but I'd like children and parents to join me in thanking all the staff that have been involved in putting this all together. Well done, thank you. because the temptation is to run forward and give your child a hug, and I'm going to ask you not to do that, because we'd like to get everybody safely home and hopefully with the right parents. So what I'm going to ask you to do shortly is to leave the MPH for us, please, and dismissal this evening will be from the doors that are opposite the field. So if you come out of either of these two doors here and you turn left and then left, the field will be in front of you and the doors there at the entrance to the hall. We need to sign out each child that they're going home with the right parent. And we also need to give them a chance just to get changed back into their uniforms or plain clothes before they come home. So I know the temptation is real. I get to live this as a parent on Wednesday, Thursday too, trust me. But I need to ask for your support so that we can get all the children home safely this evening. So thank you for coming along. Thank you for being an amazing audience. We'll see you outside. Give them one round of applause. Well done.